Dr. David Kimbrough and Dr. Randall Hughes work to unlock the secrets of the intertidal zone, where the land meets the sea.
The Water Management District puts out historical remembrances of Choctawhatchee Bay and river, and then the old timers mention all the abundance of oysters there used to be during those days.
If you go to get an oyster locally, it's not coming from Choctawhatchee Bay.
Now, are you guys still getting APALACHICOLA oysters, or
right now, I think they're coming out of Texas.
Gotcha. I can hear that.
Yeah, it's Compano Bay, Texas. APALACHICOLA has just been having a little bit too much problems, not enough fresh water coming down the river.
A big part of restoring the APALACHICOLA Bay oyster habitat involves dumping oyster shell into the bay. Those hard surfaces will hopefully be the beginnings of new reefs. Choctawhatchee Bay had their oysters dredged in the 20th century, the shells being used for things such as roadbeds. Donnie is doing his part to bring them back.
Their job made my job a little easier. Well, not only is doing, am I chucking into a 55-gallon thing, I'm going to have to throw them in a dumpster every day. So it recycles them back.
The shells he's throwing into that bin are going to be used in the Choctawhatchee Basin Alliance's oyster recycling program.
Choctawhatchee Basin Alliance started putting reefs out the year before I started working here, which is 2000. That year was 2006.
And we've been always using the fossilized shell, and we have to pay for it. We had to buy it by the dump truck load, and we started talking about how the restaurants around here serve oysters being so close to the beach, and that we should see if we could tap into that resource instead of buying the shell. We sat down, we started contacting restaurants to get our first group, and we actually had really good response. A lot of them were really excited. By our last estimates, we're almost at 4,000 cubic yards of shell that we've collected.
How long do you wait before you put it back out?
You're supposed to wait at least 6 months, but that pile over there, we waited about a year and a half. I get all the bacteria to die off, just so we don't reintroduce anything, especially now that the oysters are coming from Texas and other places. We don't want to introduce any bacteria that's not already in our habitat.
By bagging the shell, we're combining the weight of the shell into a 25 or 30 pound bag, and that doesn't get kicked around by the wave energy. And we're able to stack them and get some vertical relief, you know, to our reef, a little shape to it, which helps with the erosion as well.
And this is kind of a footprint of what the reef we're building looks like. We've kind of laid out to get the permitting done and get pictures.
They take us to one of their existing reefs.
When we do our oyster reef restoration, we've established three success measures. One of them is, have we arrested or reversed erosion? We measure that through sand accumulation around the reef. This reef is actually four bags high. It's approximately 2 feet high, but it's accumulated so much sediment, it's really only the top layer of bags is showing through right now. One of our other success measures is, have we established habitat? We take a bag from that region of the reef and we'll count all of the oysters and the size class of the oysters, the range. And then we also record if we're seeing shrimp and crabs, other shellfish, fish, try to record it all. The third, the most important or the most obvious is oyster recruitment. Are oysters actually settling on this substrate that we put down?
So am I noticing that as there are more live oysters, they start breaking through the mesh?
The mesh is all going to get covered up once they're fully developed.
The CBA relies on volunteers to pick up and bag shells, as well as to build and monitor reefs.
Today we're putting out bag shell here. It's a new shape for us. We're doing opposing crescents. One crescent will go this way and the other one will go this way along the shoreline. As you go.
We have a lot of erosion problems just with all natural boat wake, but also it's a big recreational area.
I grew up in this area, and like I said, you can see from behind us, like, the shoreline is moving further and further in, and just helps with everything. You know, I've grown up in this area, I love this area, so anything I can do to help this area, I'm going to do.
In the Grass on the Reef is funded by the National Science Foundation,